Okay, students, I will ask only question. Are they non-square numbers?
Square numbers, sir.
Are they square numbers?
Square numbers, sir.
Huh? Square numbers, sir. Yes, sir. Square numbers, sir.
Okay, my question is.
Square numbers, sir.
I will tell you. They may be square numbers. They may not be square numbers. What do you think? Do you think 100% they are square numbers? Students?
Yes, sir.
Do you think, here I can say 1057 to 23453, 7928 and this 22222, I can say 100% they are non-square numbers. 100% because they are having 732 and 8 in its unit place. Okay, that is 100%. But can you say 100% these are the perfect squares or it is a square number? Because yes, Spurti, you are telling something. Spurti, is it a square number? Can you tell 100% it is a square?
100%.
Huh?
No, sir.
No, we cannot show. It may be square number and it may not be square number. But we can say, because what happens, as I told an example, 41 and 121. Okay? You are thinking that here also one is there in unit place, here also one is there in unit place. If one is there in unit place, you are thinking these are square numbers. That is wrong. So, here one is there, all the square numbers are having one in its unit place, but not all the numbers having one in its place are square numbers. That is the thing. Here, if we are having 2, 3, 7, 8 in unit place, we can say 100% they are non-square numbers. But if they are not having 2, 3, 7, 8 in its unit place, we cannot show 100% whether they are square numbers or non-square numbers. Now you just think of it only the how to check whether the given numbers are non-squares or not. Okay? If I give many examples, you need to check that whether are they non-squares or not. Okay? And finding the square roots and whether after checking this and this, how to, whether are they square numbers or not, you will come to know in the next exercise. Now only you have to understand that whether the given numbers are non-squares or not. Okay? Students, have you understood? Students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now I will give some more things. Now, look at these examples, 77,983, 99,460, 40,008, here it is 30, 5,000, 40,000, it is 100, 500 and 400. Now my question is, which of the following numbers are non-square numbers? My question is, which of the following squares are numbers are non-square numbers? Okay. Here, as you know, what do you know about non-square numbers? If the number is having 2, 3, 7, 8 in its unit place, then that numbers are non-square numbers. Understood? But in case of zero, in case of zeros, how to check whether they are non-squares or not? Okay? So, to find that, here in this 3, in the unit place 3 is there, then we can say, show 100% it is a non-square number. Yes or no? Students, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is a non-square number. Now come to 99,460. Then do you think is it a square number or non-square number? In such cases, when the digits are when the number is ends with zeros, then in that case, how to identify it is a non-square or not? So to identify that, if the number ends with odd number of zeros, I will write here. This is very important. If a number, any number, ends with what? Odd number of zeros. Then that numbers are what? That numbers are non-square numbers. So here you know what did I tell you? The square numbers. The square numbers are always ends with even number of zeros. All the square numbers ends with even number of zeros. Okay? Or any square number which ends with the even number of zeros. Even number means 2, 4, 6, whatever number of zeros. Here if you take 100, as you know, 100 is a square number because it ends with the even number of zeros. But if you take 200, 200 is also ends with 2 zeros. But do you think 200 is a square number? This is non-square number. Or we cannot share 100% whether all the numbers having 2 zeros in it in place. But we can surely tell that if any number is having odd number of zeros or any number is ends with odd number of zeros, then that number 100% clear non-square number. Now think here, this 99,460, it ends with how many zeros? 1 0. 1 means odd. So, if any number ends with odd number of zeros, that number is non-square number. Understood? Now come to this point. Is it end with 8? If it end with 8, it is always non-square number. What about 30? It has how many digits in its last, ends with how many digits? 1 0 means it is a non-square number. Students, have you understood about this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. If any number...
Okay.
Enough. If any number ends with odd number of zeros, that number 100% non-square number. Any doubt?
Yes, sir. Yes. No, sir.
Okay. Now, Ananya... Ananya, can you hear my voice?
No, sir.
Ananya?
Yes, sir.
Only Ananya can reply.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me, Ananya, 5000 is a non-square number or square number? Ananya?
Sir, I think square number, sir.
5000 is a square number. According to you, 5000 is square number, yes? Raman Gowda? What is 5000? 5000 is a what? Square number or non-square number?
Non-square number, sir.
5000.
Non-square number.
Non-square number,
sir.
Okay. Ananya? In 5000, how many zeros? 5000 ends with how many zeros?
3, sir.
3 is odd or even? Ananya?
Odd, sir.
Ananya?
Odd.
Ananya?
Odd. Yes, sir.
Even odd numbers, even numbers, do you know that or not? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13 and so on up to infinity are odd numbers. Then how many zeros it has?
3, sir.
3 means odd? If a number ends with odd number of zeros, that numbers are called as what?
Non-square.
Then you are telling square number?
Non-square number.
Understood, students?
Yes, sir.
How to identify non-square numbers? I am not talking about square numbers, I am talking about non-square numbers. How to identify the non-square numbers among all the numbers? When the